I've been doing heirloom sewing for about 10 years now, and I only use 3 types of thread and only 1 color. Let's break it down together. Hey everyone, I'm Sarah, and like I said, I've been doing heirloom sewing for about 10 years now, and I've been doing sewing for myself for way longer than that. And with heirloom sewing, I only use 3 different types of thread, which is a little unconventional, but it works for me. So the type of thread that you use is it's directly dependent on what fabric you're using, okay? So if I'm using a thicker weight fabric, like a velvet or a corduroy, something like that, I'm going to grab a polyester thread. I love the brand Guterman. Mettler is also another great brand. I think Guterman's my favorite. But yeah, that polyester thread is going to do the best job, in my opinion, for a thicker weight fabric. But now if I'm doing something with those yummy, like Swiss batisses, those very lightweight fabrics, then what I do is I like to grab the 50 weight thread from DMC. I absolutely love this thread. I go through it like Tic Tacs. And it does a great job, in my opinion, on constructing that garment. Now, one of the things that when you're using the lighter weight fabrics in particular, they are beautiful. They are not cheap. And if they get tugged on, I mean, they're on the delicate side of life. So if, you know, a hem gets stepped on or life happens, then that fabric, if it gets tugged on enough, something is going to fail. Okay, so you've got your constructed garment, and if it gets yanked on, you know, hard enough, something is going to fail. In my opinion, it is much better to have your thread fail first, if I can get that out of my mouth, than to have your fabric rip. Because if you're, for example, my daughter's second birthday, she partied hard, and the waist seam ripped. No big deal, because the thread failed first. It was some sort of lightweight batiste. Maybe it was a voile. I can't quite remember off the top of my head. But it was definitely a lightweight heirloom fabric. And I constructed that garment up with the 50 weight DMC thread that I absolutely love. Go through it like Tic Tacs. And when that dress was tugged on, the thread failed first. And it's a very easy repair because I don't have any ripped fabric. So the last type of thread that I use for heirloom work is when I'm working with lace, or if I'm doing some applique work where I really don't want the thread to show. The thread is not so much being a part of construction as it is just, it's kind of more of like an embellishment type deal. And that is when I will grab a Madeira 80 weight thread. I also like the Aurifil. I've been using that more recently. But the Madeira one I've been using for years. Absolutely love it. They're both great threads. They're both super fine, and that's the goal that you want when you're doing lace work or any sort of applique work, because you kind of just want your thread to melt into the background, you know, just kind of like disappear and let the applique or the lace shine for what it is. 90-95% of the time, I grab the color white for all of this. I know it. It's like going to be a controversy. I can just feel it. But I grab the color white because with heirloom sewing, you know, you've got you've got lots of fabric that are white. You've got the, you know, champagnes, ecrus, light pinks, yellows. They're all these light, lovely pastels. And you would be pleasantly surprised with how well white will blend into them. I also do very little top stitching in the world of heirloom sewing, but even when I get into a little bit of top stitching, like I said, you would be pleasantly surprised with how well white blends into them. And then you're not having to have every single color under the sun and all the bobbins that go with it and manage all of it. And is this pink for that? It simplifies life, which I'm all about simplifying life. In the very few cases where I've got something of a darker fabric and I need to top stitch it, then I will grab the correct, like I will match the color to it. But with heirloom stuff, one, I very rarely top stitch, but even if I do, it just melds in there like I'm saying. I've got plenty of other videos in this beginner's heirloom series. Go check them out as you're making your way into the world. I welcome you to it. If you have any questions, of course, put them down in the comments below, and I will do my best to answer them. And as always, I appreciate y'all for watching, and I hope to catch y'all next time.